वेलकम टू द क्लास. दिस इज़ योर इंग्लिश टीचर रागनी तिवारी एंड स्टूडेंट. एज वी हैव स्टार्टेड क्लास 9th मूवमेंट बुक द चैप्टर लॉस्ट चाइल्ड, द लॉस्ट चाइल्ड एंड वी हैव कवर्ड सम पोर्शन ऑफ द स्टोरी एंड सम आर स्टिल लेफ्ट. सो लेट्स बिगिन फ्रॉम हियर. पेज नंबर 3, द फर्स्ट पैराग्राफ. As they neared the village, the child could see many other footpaths full of throngs, please underline the word throngs, converging to the whirlpool of the fair, and felt at once repelled and fascinated by the confusion of the world he was entering. Throngs means the huge crowd, okay? The huge crowd, crowd of people. Converging here means gathering. Okay, the gathering of a huge crowd, gathering of a huge crowd. So in this passage, in this paragraph, as they were about to reach the fair, they were the child with his parents. Okay, as they were about to reach the fair, the child saw huge crowd of people walking from all directions towards the fair. Okay, walking from all directions towards the fair. The dense crowd scared him. The dense crowd, the big crowd scared him, and he stepped back for a while, but the next moment he got attracted to the mind-boggling crowd of humanities. Okay, what happened there? That after a while, the next moment he got attracted with that mind-boggling crowd. Next, a sweetmeat seller hawked gulab jamun, rasgulla, burfi, jalebi at the corner of the entrance, and a crowd pressed round his counter at the foot of an architecture of many colored sweets decorated with leaves of silver and gold. The child stared open-eyed and his mouth watered for the burfi. That was his favorite sweet. I want that burfi, he slowly murmured, but he half knew as he begged that his request would not be heeded because his parents would say he was greedy. So without waiting for an answer, he moved on, murmured in a low voice, heeded, paid attention to. Okay, paid attention to, and please a request. So here at the entrance of the fair, as they entered in the fair, to one corner of a sweetmeat seller had set up a shop. At the one corner, sweetmeat seller set up its shop, and he was selling various sweets like gulab jamun, rasgulla, burfi, jalebi, etc. The sweets were displayed at different heights and were covered with foils of gold and silver. The child's mouth watered when he sighted his favorite burfi. When he saw his favorite burfi, his mouth is filled with water. He expressed his desire to get one in low voice. He expressed his desire to his parents in a very low voice. Because, why in low voice? Because he knew that his request would be refused by his parents. They would say, what the parents would say if he asked for the burfi? The parents would say that he was very greedy for the burfi. Okay, he was very greedy for the burfi, as he did not expect that his demand would be fulfilled. So he walked further, moved on further. So he walked further. A flower seller hawked a garland of gulmohar. A garland of gulmohar. The flower seller hawked a garland of gulmohar. The child seemed irresistible, drawn. He went towards the basket where the flowers lay heaped and half murmured, I want that garland. But he well knew his parents would refuse to buy him those flowers because they would say that they were very cheap. So without waiting for an answer, he moved on. Here The next stall is for what? Next stall is of flower seller. That of a flower seller, he announced, the flower seller announced that he was selling garland of Gulmohar. Hogged, the flower seller announced that he was selling the garland of Gulmohar. The child wanted one of those. The child also wanted one of those garland. He walked towards the basket of flowers. The child walked towards the basket of flowers and again announced his desire to have one in a low voice. Again, as he was unable to resist himself, so he again announced in a very low voice that I want that garland, because he knew that his demand would not be fulfilled. Why in a low voice? Very, very slowly he asked for these all things, but he was knowing that his demand is not going to be fulfilled. They would say, the parents would say, by saying say that they were very cheap garland. Again, the boy walked ahead without expecting a reply from his parents. Students, whatever the things the boy was observing and desiring to get those things, he was at that time, he was not seeing towards his parents. He was only thinking that if he asked to them, they will answer in this way. So that whatever he observed, he cited, after that he moved ahead. So student, this is it for today. Wait for your next video. Till then, take care and have a nice day.